Yeah, it's nice beer. And I was a young kid, like around 8 or 9, I decided to become a football professional in AC Milan, which is actually the competing club in Milan to Inter. And I started to practice very hard, young age. And then by the age of 17, I got a contract with Inter Milan. And I was a young, talented star playing in the under 17 national team, was the captain there. And then in Italy, I went through a depression that ended up in a suicide attempt, basically. And this, I wrote a book about in 2007 called In the Shadow of San Siro. And I think that book is about, you know, trying to find your place in the football world. And also, it's a coming of age story, basically, where I found myself being, you know, locked in this dream in many ways. I realized I changed during the journey and started to look for other things in life. So I think what the movie does is capture this 16, 17 year old who comes to a new country, doesn't know the language, is in the middle of his dream in one of the biggest clubs in the world, and realizing after a while that this is not his place, basically. And in many ways, it's, you know, it's depict the football world and the football industry, but at the same time, it's a story about, you know, breaking free of something, you know, breaking free of old ideas about yourself and about structures that have, you know, constrained you in many ways. So that I would say, yeah. I think there is definitely things in the movie that can be an eye-opening thing for the football world, of course, in how they treat young players, in what kind of organization they need around young players. But most of all, it's a story about a young man. It's a coming of age story. It's about the first love, you know, coming to a new country, trying to reach a goal and so on. So it's not only a cautious tale in that way that, you know, I want to you know, give a message to the football world. It's also just an artistic piece that I think Ronnie and the team have really made come to life, you know. It was strange, of course, to see it the first time. I mean, I saw a kind of rough cut in Copenhagen when there was still no music on it and so on. But just to see the images and how they worked with the specific scenography and so on, and how close it was to what I experienced and the rooms I was in, it was amazing and very surrealistic in a way. And then when it comes to Erik, I'm just, I don't know what to say. He captures, you know, really the anxiety and the drive and everything that I was having in me at the time. But also, it's just a very impressive performance in that way, that he's almost in every picture of the movie. And that is almost a sports performance itself, to really carry the movie in that way. So I bow my head for Eric's performance. I really do. I mean, me and Ronnie met in Berlin in 2011, which is quite some time ago. And I was there for 5 years trying to, to speak frankly, like reinvent myself in many ways. I had been in the football industry and I needed Berlin as a way to, you know, break out of that and find a new identity and trying to explore writing and so on. And Ronnie happened to be there at the same time, doing a similar journey in a way, even though he's been a writer since he was 16 years old. So we found each other, I think, in a common kind of mentality and competitiveness and all that he could see in Ronnie. In Martin, in this character, and found a way into the book. So then it was a dialogue from that point since 2011, where we also, you know, we helped each other out with scripts and so on, and I knew that Ronnie had a good pen, but at the time when he took on the movie, he had just done one short, so it was a trust thing, you know. We shook hands, and I just felt in my stomach that, okay, he will be best suited for you know, bringing this story to the screen. It was a stomach decision, basically. Yeah. This is a movie also, of course, about mental health and being, you know, lost in different structures and being a young man around other men and the, you know, the the expectations that comes with that. So yeah, hopefully that it can make some people feel less alone in where they are. But then, I mean, the movie have also a more critical finger pointed to the football industry and how these young people are treated, because a lot of time we talk about, yeah, what can young people do, or like what should they do. I think we need to talk about this on a structural level, like what makes people think, you know, feel bad and have mental health in the first place, you know, problems with mental health. So yeah, it's, I would say, yeah.
What you would most like to see change within that culture of football, and if you do think it is still a toxic culture?
I think it differs. I think it's hard to say that it's in one way all over, but I think it's been a toxic masculinity culture in many ways, where it's an idea of the survival of the fittest, and you need to, you know, be strong, and you need to be in certain ways to fit in. And I want to you know, lift the dialogue and the discussion around this to, like, yeah, the players in these teams, you have doctors for almost every bone in the body in these teams, but you have very few doctors for the head or for the soul. And when you go through all these things as a young player, I mean, that's what you need. And if you're, you know, secure and you feel you're in a safe space and you feel good with the people around you, you will also perform better on the pitch. And that's the message somehow that I want to throw out there, because if you're just going to be like, okay, he didn't make it, he wasn't strong enough, then you will lose a lot of good players as well. So the football world needs to create an environment that is better suited for different kind of individuals in this football world. I had to, you know, step away from football for a long time, really many years, like not seeing it, or I had no interest. And of course, the first year it was almost traumatic. It was. Nowadays, I have a good relationship with the football, and I want to differ between the football industry and football itself, because football, I still love to play football with friends or go out to kick the ball sometimes. That's not gone, you know. It's still a very, very great and fun sport to, you know, to do. So yeah, I really want to differ between football industry and football itself. So today I would say I have a good relationship to the football itself, but I'm in discussion and dialogue with the football industry, and I want to, you know, raise questions around it.